What's going on, everyone? MetalBlade427 here, and I welcome you back to Skies of Arcadia Legends for the GameCube. In the last episode, we got here to the Maw of Tartas, that is where we are, the Mouth of Hell, which is a bunch of caverns underneath Valua. And pretty much, we flew around, very boring area to say the least, picked up the two crystal chests that were here, and made our way to the end fairly simply. I mean, if it wasn't for me showing off all the Blue Rogue's attacks and everything like that, it wouldn't have taken us long at all to get here at all. And it's not even like this is a good grinding spot either. Like, there are better areas in the game to grind stronger enemies to get, you know, gold and experience and things along that way. Looperland, for example, that's what I'd rather grind rather than here. This is just boring and kind of... yeah, stagnant, you know, it's all the same, it's all the muddy colors, and it's all kind of, you get a little yellow here and there, because it's under Valua, but, it could be better, whatever. I don't know, as I said in the last episode, the Dark Rift set the bar so high for, ship dungeons that, I don't know if there was anything that could ever top it. I don't think so, and this probably had the potential to, but didn't, sadly enough. Anyway, we made our way through. Let's go ahead and finish it up. So straight through here we go. And this will actually bring us into this room. So now you have like this chamber here. You know, you have all these like different like symbols or whatever on the side. You know, you have just kind of other, you know, stuff that's around. And below us we have what looks to be the yellow seal, because it's 5 points, you know, it's the sign of the yellow moon, all that down there. And if that's below us, then above us, oh boy, look at that. Well, for one, it's just really pretty, because if you go all the way up and you get past, again, the muddy colors of it all, you get a really cool looking, you know, chamber of sorts that this thing was sealed in. I don't remember if Fina said its name, but the yellow gigas, we'll just go with that. So you get this really cool, you know, all this design and everything to it, but, you know, right above you, oh man, look at this, look at that. Oh boy, here we go. We're just gonna be going right at it. Whoa. Oh, okay. Is that... that is Yeligar, the Yellow Gigas. Huh. Silvite mages managed to put him to sleep. Then they sealed him in here. Yeligar is extremely powerful, so it's best that we don't wake him. The crystal is in Yeligar's possession. We have to find a way to remove it without waking him.
Yeah, easier said than done, Fina.
Oh, wait a minute. Green light means go. Oh, boy, he's... guys, he's charging up. That's electricity. That's a lot of bad going on right there. Great, he's awake. If we stay here, we won't be able to dodge the lightning. We have to get away from him. Engines, full reverse. Yeah, where are you going, Vice? You're in a giant cave. Even if you go back through the cave, he'll still try to hit you. Oh, wow. Oh, energy pillars. Now remember, Valua couldn't crack that at all with any of their abilities. Yeligar, after being asleep for all that time, freshly woken up and stretching, because you know you gotta like stretch out, can crack it in an instant. That's how powerful this Gigas is. And this is bad. He made breaking the seal look easy. This isn't a good sign. It looks like we're gonna have to fight him to get the crystal. Battle stations, let's take that thing down. Jumping right into our ship battle. Oh boy, this is gonna be fun. Very interesting design, that's for sure. Kinda crab spider-ish or whatever.
Yeligar, ancient records say its thunder tore open the skies themselves, and its roar shook the ground.
Whoa. It doesn't sound like a very friendly Gigas. Vice, we should be extra careful. Nah, we're alright, don't worry about it. In fact, I'm so alright,
I'm going to take this ancient cannon and I'm going to blow a hole in it right there. And you, Ica, why don't you take an apple wax? No, not a hex shell. Take an apple wax, throw that there. And let's see, I have 7 left. I can't really do too much with that. Let's just go ahead and gear grease. And yeah, okay, gear grease. Good. So, here we are up against the yellow Gigas Yeligar. 150,000 HP, 19,050 experience, 8,700 gold. Get yourself a Captain Stripe and the Thunder Cutlass, which is a weapon for Vice, at the end of battle. Don't worry about using your magic cannon. There's absolutely nothing against him that's, you know, effective enough to use it. Definitely don't use any yellow magic or else he'll either do zero or he'll heal him. Either way, you don't want either. Generally speaking, he'll have 2 different types of attack, Voltigar and Photon Charge, but every so often he will do the Thunder Crash ability, which is a very powerful attack. Yeah, he may actually do some decent damage to us. So here's Photon Charge. It'll fire upwards and then rain down electricity on the Delphinus and do 1,310 damage. Oh boy. Man, I love having my character so high and just adding so much energy to the Delphinus. Yep, we did just as much damage to him as he did to us. This is going to be one hell of a fun fight. So, there is ways of knocking him off balance, but you need to have enough SP to use the Moonstone Cannon to do it. And at this point, we really don't have much going for us right now. So, let's see. I would like to Orala. So if I do that at the end of the battle, that'll be good. Let's see, can I fire it off? All right, that's fine. We'll fire that there. Fina, why don't we go ahead and quicken the ship just to make it a little bit faster. And Enrique, Arala's going to, like, power it up anyway. So, you know what? Oh, is that all I can do? I can only do one? Do I really want to? Is there anybody else I can use? That's the next question. Raises your attributes. Sure, let's do it. Speed up the ship so this way we can actually go first. Because that's what Quicka does for the ship. It enables you to go first in a particular round. So that's why we were able to Quicka anyway. He's going to Photon Charge us again. Yeah, this is... Again, one of the many moves in this game that appears more devastating than it actually is. Alright, so now Ilkimus will go next, so there we go. Raises our ship's parameter, so I think that's like dodge and quick and anything other than attack and defense. Because we already have attack and defense up with the apple wax. Alright, he's assessing the damage. We're going to be firing a torpedo here. I don't know exactly what Yeligar is based off of, but... he's very five-pointish. You can kind of get that because he has his head and he has his 4 legs that are sticking out from the side. So, ooh, Voltigar, good. I'd like to see this attack. It's actually a really cool attack. He, like, strafes an electrical beam ahead and you again think, oh my god, he cut us in half with electricity. Really? Oh man, why are we scared of this Gigas? Probably because, you know, once he's, like, extremely powered up, then he can do some damage. But honestly, because he just woke up, he still doesn't know exactly what gear it is. So we can take advantage of this and kind of smack him around a little bit while he's weak. It looks kind of flat. Maybe we should try attacking it from above or below. Might be easier to hit that thing. So, honestly, I don't think it really matters. I think below will give you the all green and attack will give you the 2 crits. So, honestly, I'm going to go above. Let's try attacking it from above. Increase altitude. All this really does... All it really does is it kind of makes it so whatever move Yeligar does... like, if you go up, he'll do the Photon Charge. If you go down, he'll do Voltigar. So... it really does not matter at all, and I'm going to take Vice, and Vice, you will go ahead and you will Apple Wax in the beginning. Ica, take this art hit there. Fina, it's fine, and Enrique, I'm sure we'll stretch that for. Alright, I will meet you at the end of this round. Honestly, now that I think about it,
probably be the better idea to go below anyway. I mean, your cannons will be able to aim up and hit them, because so far I have missed every shot except for my torpedoes, and then you kind of hit his weak point underneath, which is like his belly, you know? Damn, not a single weak point. More importantly, is it just me, or does that thing look a little bit more active? Is the seal weakening on it or something? Perhaps. But whatever the reason, it appears it will be building up for some sort of attack. I wish there was a way we could knock it off balance like we did with all the other gigas, but it's just too big. Anything short of the Moonstone Cannon probably won't even make that thing budge. And you know what? That's exactly what we're going to use. Fire the Moonstone Cannon right on it, and you will actually knock it off balance. And by doing that, you're able to just, you know, kill it and go crazy. Let's do that. Oh, I can't. There's no more turns. Damn it. No. How about the 5-inch? No. Wait, I can't use it. Oh, because she is using it. Ah, I see. All right. Nah, we'll do that. And then Enrique, you can gear grease here. But, yeah, so I figured out, wow, okay, that's better. That's a lot more damage to that thing than I was doing before. Yeah, definitely choose to go below it in order to hit the weak point. And you definitely want to fire the Moonstone Cannon there, because that will knock it off balance. Firing the Moonstone and making sure your ship goes before Yeligar will knock it off balance, and its powerful attack, that thunderstorm or whatever, will... I don't think it'll happen, actually. It may not happen, or it may just not do as much damage to the ship as it possibly could. Not that it matters. We've been taking a beating from this guy, and as you can see, my health is nowhere near even in the danger zone or whatever it is. So, alright, we got a gear grease going on here. We lost the 3-inch cannon because we weren't looking at him. It's reasons like this where I wish I could control the ship myself. It's like, I know we need some distance between, you know, us in order to use the Moonstone Cannon, but come on, man, let's go. I'm not even facing him there anyway! I wasn't facing him!
Moonstone Cannon, fire!
Oi! Alright, knock him down. Stupid 3-inch cannon getting lost. Or foot, sorry, 3-foot. Ah! The health! Oh, the health is right there! Oh, man! That sucks! But the target was lost, which means he couldn't hit us. Alright, that did it! It's off balance! Haha! Leave it to the Moonstone Cannon! Alright, everyone, now's our chance! Open fire! And we can do the Moonstone Cannon one more time, so let's go ahead and do that to finish it. And I'm just going to guard straight through. And let's go ahead and energy beam him to the face!
Moonstone Cannon, fire!
For the win! Okay, it wasn't at the face, it was more on the side. But that's alright, whatever. Straight through. Goodbye, Yeligar. Down he goes. I think he falls, like, into the Maw of Tartas, never to be seen again. Nice, good stuff. Yep, there he goes. And he explodes in an energy blast or something like that. Which is kind of sucky, because I'd like to have seen him, but that's alright. We did it! That wasn't easy. Actually, I take that back, it kind of was. But still, I have to be dramatic. Nice crater. Awesome. It just so happens the yellow moon crystal is in the dead center. It's amazing that we were able to get it before the Armada. Well, since we got the yellow crystal, we should head back to Crescent Island.
This is the 5th moon crystal that we've collected. And now, my quest is finished.
Fina.
Aww. I don't want Fina to go.
And we received the yellow moon crystal. Kind of a bittersweet thing there, because again, it's the end of Fina's mission. What is she going to do now? But I guess it's more of our thing of what are we going to do now. So we have... I don't think the Maw of Tartas is even around. I mean, it's still here. You can still go down into the dungeon. Yeah, right here. So it says Maw of Tartas. But instead of Stonehenge, it's a big hole in the ground that Yeligar created. Like, there's no other thing that happened. I don't even think... Where is the crater that he made? Ah, jeez. So, Yeligar's gone. You can go back down into the hole if you want to go through the Maw of Tartas, but I don't, so back to Upper Sky, and we need to make our way back home, which would be due east. Due east. Hey, it's the ladder that I couldn't find. Ugh. But yeah, like, when you really sit there and think about it, it's like, Fina, what's Fina gonna do? How is she gonna get to, wherever she's from? Because remember, in the very beginning of the game, her ship got lost. So hopefully there's somewhere on this planet that we haven't, or in Arcadia, that we haven't seen yet. And we can bring her there or something? I don't know. You know what? Let's head back to the island and discuss it. Hey, long time no see. Wow, you've got yourself a nice little base set up here.
Ooh.
Gilder! I heard that you sailed around the world. As always, kid, sounds like you've been trying to get yourself into more trouble. I came here to hear all about your travels. That and for a good meal. Good old Gilder. Pleasure before business. Oh look, our animal is there. I can't tell what it is, but it looked cute, I guess. I don't know. But it's also cool that Gilder came back. So we're starting to see all of these fourth party members come back into the game in one way, shape, or form. Because we saw Drachma not too long ago. Wherever he is, I don't know. And now we have Gilder. So you went to Yafutoma and then on to the land of ice, huh? Just listening to your stories makes my adrenaline flow. And so in the end, you collected the 5 moon crystals. Nice work. We got them all! And since all of them are together, I suppose that means Fina will be taking them with her when she heads home soon.
Yes.
Actually, there was something that was bothering me from earlier. Fina, where exactly did you come from? I mean, where are you going home to? Fina?
The place to which I must return, the place where both Ramirez and I were born and raised, is the Great Silver Shrine. It is in a place high above the cloud of the sky.
The Great Silver Shrine?
Long ago, when the rain of the destruction fell upon the land, and most of the world's population was killed, all seemed lost. The most powerful Sylvite mages met at the shrine. They combined their energies to send it into the sky, above the destruction. They escaped the horrible fate that fell upon the rest of the world by rising above the destruction. Ever since then, from above, we have sworn to protect the people from this world, from the same fate that our ancestors suffered. That is the primary mission of the remaining Sylvites. The Great Silver Shrine is high above the clouds where no ship can reach it. I plan to take the moon crystals back to the Great Silver Shrine so that no one will ever be able to abuse their power again.
But how are you going to get home?
If I can get back the ship I came in, then I should be able to make it home. But when I was attacked by Valua, my ship sank beneath the clouds.
Yes, I remember. You're talking about that ship you were flying when Alfonso attacked you.
It appears that we must find another way of getting Fina home. But if we find a way to get Fina back home, does that mean we'll have to say goodbye? We'll never see her again. Lately, I sometimes find myself thinking. I started thinking, if I'm unable to find a way home, that I'll be able to stay here with everyone. I'm sorry. That's so silly of me. My orders were to gather the moon crystals and return to the Great Silver Shrine with them.
Uh-oh. What's happening in Valua now? Can never be anything good, especially with Galshian's concern.
Ramirez, what is the status on the construction of Dangral Island?
Yes, my lord.
The construction of the port is complete, and Deloco's flagship is currently being fitted so that it will be able to submerge into deep sky. I've also received word that the elevator leading to the bottom of deep sky has been completed as well. Excellent. The time grows near. Soon, the foolish Empress and the rest of the people of the world will bow before my might. No, not just the people. The people, and even those revered moons. Soon, they will all be in my grasp. The people, the lands, and even the moons, they will belong to me. You shall reign supreme, Lord Galshian. Tomorrow morning, I will leave for Dangral. I wish to oversee the final stages of the construction myself. And tell the other admirals to assemble at Dangral. I wish to know where they stand. Yes, Lord Galshian. I walk the path of death and destruction. I know you are a Silvite. If you wish to change your mind, now is the time. I chose long ago to walk the path that you walk upon, Lord Galshian. I shall forever be at your side. And I will cut down any of those that block our path. It is my duty. It is my purpose.
And so the plot thickens! Oh man, the only thing is that Vice has no idea what's going on. There is a way for us to find out. I think it's when we're getting ready to leave, Gilder is going to be talking to us. But before we do that, remember we did upgrade, Ilkimus's lab. So let's go on in here and actually take a look at what it turned into. And it should be over to the left. And yep, there we go. We actually bought him a giant cauldron. Filled with, I don't know, we can't really see it, but it's all bubbly and thingies like that. I wonder what kind of pink liquid is for. Hope it's not medicine. I wish I could step up on the ladder in order to look at it. And then he has this, like, interesting formula, you know, over here on the wall. Not 100% sure what it is that he's trying to figure out, what mad scientist thing he's brewing, but let's actually talk to him again. Oh, hello, Vice. Thanks to you, I have this wonderful lab where I can create medicines for you and your crew. I'm glad you like it. Ilkimus, I've been wanting to ask you, why did you decide to devote your entire life to medicine? Before you joined our crew, you lived on that little island all by yourself, mixing ingredients and making potions. Haha, you've been wondering why I decided to become a hermit. Well, I will tell you. Perhaps you will understand why I chose this life. My parents were both nobles from Upper City, so during my childhood, I was well taken care of. Because of my family's wealth, I was able to buy all of the books I wanted. I read all the time, you see. One day, on my way to the bookstore, I saw a very sick man from Lower City. He crawled into Upper City on his hands and knees. He was begging for money so he could buy medicine, but no one would help him. I ran to the shop to try and help the man. When I returned, he was already dead. I felt so helpless. From that day on, I decided that I would devote my life to helping others. I spent days alone in my room reading all about the different types of medicines and potions. In time, I became one of Alua's best researchers. I wanted to make medicines that the people in Lower City could afford. I wanted to help people, but Valua had other plans for me. They wanted me to make weapons for their military. Shortly after, I fled Valua and found an island where I can continue my studies. Sorry if my story seemed a bit long. I believe in you, Vice. Although you are a warrior, you are fighting for the right cause. And that is why I wanted to aid you in your fight. I will do everything in my power to assist you and your crew. And then he
goes and helps us. So there you go. You get a little bit of a background on Ilkimus right there, because he was so random to find. Like, Ryokan was kind of random, but being that he was like a hermit in the middle of Yafutoma, you're like, he seeked the great warrior. Okay, that's legit. Him, it's like, this is random. Speaking of things that are random, let's look at his shop upgrade, shall we? So, he has his basic crystals. He has his basic other things like that. But now you have the third page. Full of seeds. Power seeds, will seeds, vigor seeds, which is defense, quick seeds, HP and MP. You can buy all of these seeds at any time. This is why gold is important, because you can go to this Pirata seed and you can go 68. I can afford 68 Pirata seeds, which means I can take all of that power and apply it to vice. Broken. At this point in the game, you can make your characters ridiculously broken and never have to worry about leveling them up again, because you can just go to Looperland, get a gajillion gold or whatever, come here, buy all of these stat boosting items, and just go nuts. I am not going to do that yet. I want to kind of make it a little bit further into the main story before I hyperpower all my guys, but just know this is a thing. And it's not breaking the game, it's not cheating or anything like that, at least I don't think so, because the game opens it up to you. It's like an option for you to play. It's not a cheat or anything, it's just, if you want to hyperpower your guys, go farm gold, come back, and go nuts. Ah, that's so awesome. I gotta sell some stuff anyway. I think if I talk to him, he'll actually have, yes, little concoction that he made of. It's called the Ilkimix. Interesting name. Or yeah. So, take a few moments for you to take effect, but it won't be Can't use it in battle, but for 4,000 gold, he'll give us 10. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and take it. Yeah, boom, we get 10 Ilkimixes. And I believe what those do is they heal everybody. Let's go in. Let's go take a look, shall we? Let's go here. Let's go to items. And it's going to be at the end. There we go. Special mix of herbs. This amazing potion will fully restore the party's HP and MP. Think of it like a tent that you would find in like Final Fantasy or something, but you can use it anywhere. You use it, everybody has full HP, everybody has full MP. For 4,000 gold, you get 10 of them. Oh, so worth it. Again, just worth it. Ilkimus is amazing. He is a great, great character to have. Oh, you know what I'm going to do while I'm here? Let's go ahead and Thunder Cutlass, an ancient cutlass made from Yeligar's hardened skin. Some say can cut through lightning. Sure! Let's put it on yellow and call it a good day. Awesome. And I think... Oh, nope. Last thing I want to do, because I do want to do this, because we will have him for a little bit longer. With 5 moon berries, I only need 4, and I'll be able to unlock this. Enrique summons 1 enemy to the Colosseum to be judged for its crimes. With 4 moon berries, we unlock his final skill, the Judgment. And I will show this off probably in the next episode. We will have Enrique for a little bit longer, so I'd like to show that off. Let's head ourselves back to the Delphinus, and I think this is where Gilder will stop us in order to give us some information. So that entire scene that we saw with Galshian and Ramirez, obviously Vice doesn't know anything like that, so there would be no reason for him to go any place. But I want to say... Gilder speaks to us here? Yeah, here it is. Okay. Hey, Vice. Thanks for the food yesterday. It was delicious. Oh, Gilder, you're leaving already? Yeah, I need to get going. But before I go, I have some news for you. I found out some information on the Armada's latest project. I just heard about this the other day. It appears that Valua has begun advancing into the lower altitudes. I heard that north of Pirate Isle, somewhere beneath the clouds, there's a building, a base, on Dangrel Island. It's just a rumor, but I heard that they're building a ship that can go into deep sky. Deep sky? Yes, beneath the thick layers of clouds, immersed in total darkness, there is a bottom of the world. No one has ever seen what's below the clouds. Some people say that it's completely dead.
could they be looking for down there?
I don't know, but Fina's ship sank beneath the clouds, right?
You're right. That must be what they're after.
Thanks, Gilder. We'll go check it out.
You don't need to thank me. Good luck, Vice.
And there you have it! Here's our next destination. We need to head to Dangrel Island, and to do that, we will be there in the next episode. I transitioned into that very weird. So, anyway, yes, that's what we'll be doing in the next episode. Thank you all for watching. Be sure to like and comment down below, and if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button so you can get equipped with me, MetalBlade427. I do have one little side stop I will be doing before we head over to Dangrel, but honestly, it is along the way, so we'll be able to grab it. We will also grab our last discovery that we can get for right now, and we'll actually be finishing up a lot of stuff soon. Dangrel has the last two moonfish on it, and then we can actually complete that too. So we're getting close to a lot of finishings in terms of this game and everything, so it's getting pretty exciting. Anywho, you guys have a good one, and I will catch you all later.